Hello, everyone. I'm Sesha Mani. I'm a principal group product manager in Microsoft Information Production team in Microsoft. In this video, I'm going to share with you Microsoft Information Production in Teams, SharePoint, OneDrive, and Exchange, part one, an overview. In this session, we will learn about two major objectives. The first one is, what are the challenges with information protection while using the information in cloud services? Second of all, how the Microsoft Information Protection uniquely solves for these challenges in our Microsoft 365 services. I divided this video into three major chapters. The first one is, what are the challenges in information protection? The second one is, how the Microsoft Information Protection is going to solve for these challenges? And then finally, I'll summarize our learnings from this session as well. So let's see, what are the challenges in information protection? As we all know, digital transformation is really resulting in exponential growth of digital data. And trying to safeguard all this data, classification is fundamental to it. However, with manual classification, it's not going to meet the scale needs of your enterprises and organizations. Second of all, the information protection doesn't need to be just only at the file level. It needs to be at multiple levels. And also, with the granular controls that is covering all the scenarios and the risks. And what I mean by that is, including your users, both internal and external users accessing your data, as well as the devices that they use to access your corporate data, and being able to control, be it a managed device or their own personal device. Especially in these days of remote working, users use their personal devices to access their corporate data. So you need to be able to control access even from those unmanaged devices as well. So it is very important that your information protection strategy takes into account all these scenarios and risks as well. So these are the major two challenges that faces us in this cloud services world. Now let's take a look how Microsoft Information Protection is uniquely designed to solve these challenges for you. Let me first cover a couple of customer benefits of Microsoft Information Protection. First and foremost, it's built-in in Microsoft 365. Its built-in labeling and production experience spans across all Office 365 apps that your users are already familiar with, such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Also, across all Office 365 services like Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams as well, and other Microsoft services like Power BI, Edge, and Windows 2. So it's built in right within the Microsoft 365 ecosystem. Second, it's intelligence driven. The accuracy of this classification is so precise because it uses the machine learning capabilities and trainable classifiers, as well as the exact data match-like technique, so that the precision of the classification is much, much higher than any other classifications. Third, it's a unified approach across all the data sources, be it on-premises or Microsoft 365 sources, or even other third-party services through our CASB solutions like Microsoft Cloud App Security. You have a single control pane using our Microsoft 365 Compliance Center. So you have a single administrative console to configure these policies, and all the data sources can be now protected with this. Last but not least, it's extensible too. You can use our MIP SDK to extend these protection and experiences and capabilities across other non-Microsoft products as well. When we think about Microsoft Information Protection, we see this is available for you at the three levels. The first one is protection at the service level. So you can take a Microsoft team or a SharePoint site and being able to protect that holistically. Second, at the given document level. So you can protect a specific document or a list of files. And then not only that, you can prevent data losses of your sensitive data, even if your users have mistakenly shared or accidentally shared the data. Now let's take through each one level at a time. First, protection at the Teams and SharePoint sites level. As I mentioned earlier, in the single control pane in Microsoft 365 Compliance Center, as you can see in this picture, you can configure and create the sensitivity labels and apply appropriate policies for your sites and group settings. For example, you can control who can join a team. You can configure your privacy setting, either be it a public or a private. Public means anyone in your organization can join the team, discover and join the team. Privacy means only the selective private members can discover and join the particular team. You can also control whether the team owner can add guest users to the given team or not. The second major control is around access to the team's sites from the unmanaged devices. In this remote work world, as users use their personal devices to access corporate data, it is super critical to ensure that your device policies are appropriately set. You can choose to say allow full access from the unmanaged device, or you can say allow limited web-only access. That means they can view the content in the browser, but they cannot download, print, and sync in their devices. Or you can choose to say completely block access from their unmanaged devices. Then the third control I want to mention is the granular control of the external sharing for the files in the Teams and SharePoint sites. As you know, in SharePoint for many years, that external sharing policies have been existed. Now we are bringing that in conjunction with these MIP sensitivity labels as well. And you have a granular scheme of levels to choose from. You can either ultimately block external sharing, completely block, that means only internal users can access those files, or you can allow existing guest or new guest users to come into the team and access it, or you can even say anonymous links can be sent for those files in your teams, and that means anyone who has the link can access the files too. So depending on the sensitivity of the content, you choose the right appropriate sharing level. Now, let's take a look at it in a demo here. So here I am in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center. For this organization, I have created four labels: general, confidential, top secret, and M&A top secret. Let's take a look at the confidential label. You can see this label has many policies. It has sites and group settings, as well as content marking for files, and doesn't have any encryption policies. Let's actually zoom in on the site and group settings. As you can see here, there are three policies associated for site and group settings. The first one is the privacy policy. It's configured as private. That means only the members of the team can discover and join this particular team. Second one is the device policy, allow limited and web-only access. This means when users access these content from unmanaged devices, they get to see them only in the web. They cannot download, sync, or print the files from these teams. Third one is external sharing. As you can see, it's disabled for this particular resource because confidential resources, you don't want to enable external sharing. So those are the three major policies that are now configured for this confidential label. Let's actually look at the specifically on external sharing, how the settings are. So for this label, I've chosen only people in my organization. So that's why it is the last option is enabled. However, if I want to, for some other sensitivity, I can choose existing guests or new and existing guests. That means I can invite new external users to these teams and SharePoint sites. Also, if I want to, I can choose even anyone. Users can share the files and folders using this link that does not require any sign-in. So it's just the most lenient option as well. So as you can see, different granular controls of external sharings are capable now available for sensitivity label as well. Now let's take a look at it from an end user experience perspective. Here, I am logged in as Jeremy, as an end user, and in the investment banking team, and you can see the team is labeled as confidential. And if I want to, I can go to the team settings and change this label to some other label as well. But I'm going to leave it as it is for confidential. Now, because it's labeled as confidential, corresponding policies will automatically get enforced. Let's take a look. If I go to the files tab for this particular team, and then I'm going to try to share a file with an external user, alan@fabricm.com. And as you can see, the error message tells me that organization's policies do not allow to share this with the external users. This is because the confidential label had the external sharing disabled. That's the policy that automatically gets enforced here. Totally makes sense. From an end user perspective, I'm protective in my device. However, the information is also protected. Now, if I go ahead and open that particular file, I see that there is an informational message that tells me that your organization is not allowed to download, print, or sync using this device. This is because I'm now accessing this document from my personal device. And because of that, I'm not allowed to download, print, or sync. And it protects the corporate data while at the same time making me productive, still able to get my work done. So that was a quick overview of protection of teams and sites with the MIP sensitivity labels. Now, let's take a look at the next level, which is protection at the document level. Users can classify the office documents. With sensitivity labels, many protection policies such as encryption, visual marking, header, and footer are available now. The main aspect here is the protection will persist with the document towards its lifecycle. What that means is even after you download the file from Microsoft 365, the protection policies will stay with the file. Even though manual classification helps the end users to classify the file, but in the scale at which the digital data is growing, you really also need the automatic classification. Auto-classification, complementing the manual classification, will help you to meet your scale needs of classification in the organizations. However, creating auto-labeling policy is a super important step. You want to create a rule, try this out and simulate it, ensure that the rules are catching the appropriate files, and then once you are happy with and fine-tuned it, then you actually roll out auto-labeling policies. For that, Policy Simulator is here to help you. You can simulate the policy, see the results, fine-tune the policy. Once you are happy, you can start rolling out the policy. Auto-classification is also available in the Office experience. That means as the users author the file, the recommendations can come and tell the users to label the files as well. At the same time, even if the users forget, in the service, in SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams, automatically the file gets labeled as well. Not only the protection aspects, we also help you to get the end user productivity experience with these protected documents. For example, co-authoring on the protected document is possible now. I can now bring in my colleague who has access to the same protected file, and we both can co-author in the document. Not only that, I can even search for protected files in Microsoft 365 services. With all these capabilities, productivity of the end users will grow up even for the protected documents. Now, let's take a look at a quick demo of this. Here I am in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center in the Sensitivity Labels tab. I'm going to look at the top secret label, and let's look at the details of the policies associated with this label. I'm going to go ahead and click Next and see the encryption policies associated with this label. And as you can see, this allows only the Contoso Bank employees to have access to the files that are labeled with top secret. And this is an important encryption policy because I don't want any external users to be able to access these confidential or top secret labeled files. Now, let's take a look at it from the end user experience perspective. So here I have a PowerPoint file open in Teams. And this file is labeled as top secret, as you can see in the watermark clearly mentions in the middle. And also the header and footer has the top secret text as well. If I want to change the label of this file, I can go to the sensitivity option, and then I can choose a different label as well. For this, I'm going to leave it as a top secret. And then more importantly, this file has an encryption policy. And that means here at the bottom, the top secret icon, the secure icon, shows you that the encryption policy is in enforcement. So that was a quick overview of protection at the document level with the MIP sensitivity labels. Now let's take a look at the next level, which is prevention of data loss. As you know, data loss prevention policies for SharePoint, OneDrive, and Exchange have existed for many years. Now we are evolving this story even further. You can create the DLP rules using built-in 100 plus sensitive information types, and we keep increasing these sensitive information types available out of the box. You can create DLP rules, such that once the sensitive file is detected, it will block external guest sharing and access for sensitive documents, even if users have accidentally shared those files previously. And also, we can now block the anonymous links as well. If the sensitive file is shared as anonymously before, DLP detects the sensitive file and now marks the anonymous access blocked for those files. With Teams usage increasing, we're also looking at the Teams messages can be protected with DLP policies as well. You can educate and guide your end users with notifications with our DLP policy tips. You can use the Security and Compliance Center to create and customize the DLP policy settings for Teams messages. Finally, I want to call out the Endpoint DLP. This is our next generation DLP solution. With this built-in and cloud-powered information protection service, it allows you to create policies for your Windows devices that you are managing in your organization, and also able to either audit or block copying of sensitive data to other devices, for example, USB devices. It provides visibility to the data that are at risk and adversary data exploitation attempts are being made in your organization. Please check out the DLP skilling videos for more details. So that actually wraps up the three levels in Microsoft Information Protection. Protection at the service level for Teams and SharePoint sites, protection at the document level, and also using DLP, you can prevent data losses as well in your organizations. Not only that, you are able to control at the granular level across various scenarios and risks that are pertaining to the users, be it internal or external users, or the devices that the users are using to access your corporate data. That brings us to the final chapter of this video, summarizing our learnings. Microsoft Information Protection offers both automatic and manual classifications to meet your scale needs of the classification. As the digital data is growing in your enterprise, we believe that Microsoft Information Protection is the right solution to meet your classification needs. Second of all, Microsoft Information Protection offers the levels at multiple levels, file level, and also at the Teams and SharePoint sites level too. Not only that, even at the granular controls across various scenarios and risks arising from the unauthorized users and also from unmanaged devices. Here are some of the useful links for the capabilities that I've covered in this session, both the blogs and the documentation links. And also, here are the links for Microsoft Information Protection all up across the variety of topics. On behalf of the Microsoft Information Protection team, I'd like to invite you to engage with us at our Yammer link here. Also, watch our other skilling videos across the topics of MIP, DLP, and other governance topics as well. With that, I wanted to thank you for your time today listening to this video, and I hope it was informative and insightful for you. Thank you very much.